Grab a snack and a drink and a couple of peas. Man, game on your channel. We gon' make you laugh now. How serious can you take us? Gon' have to tell somebody what's gon' have you laughing later. Push the envelope, throw the script in the trash. That's our job, you just sit back and laugh.
Laugh now, laugh later.
Come take a little trip with the cast. In the end, I can bet you be laughing.
Laugh now, laugh later. Laugh now, laugh later.
And if the summer
summer, I know you gon' miss me. For we've been together like Nike Airs and crisp tees. Estates with polo fleeces. Purple label with the logo secret. Give me a couple years, but I might just sneak in. A couple words and like peaches and herb. We'll be reunited and feel so hood. How the whole world saying, I still so good. Well, I do this in my slumber, summer. I ain't none of these half-ass newcomers. You know how I do, summer. I drop heat when you bring the sun up. The combo make you sack up. I pick a gun up. You back up. They know I'm not no fronter. I don't talk. You. I just flip it on ya. Sorry, Lance. I'm just trying to advance my quotes. I ain't making you the butt of my jokes. But let's not stray from what I came to say to my beloved. Think we need some time away. They say if you love it, you should let it out. It's Cajun.
What up, people? Your boy T Turner, laugh now, laugh later, and we've reached the end, man. It's so hard. That's right. To say goodbye. This is the final episode of season 5. We are done. We signing off, and we good. So I want y'all to make sure you kick back, relax, get your popcorn, and enjoy it because we're going out with a bang, bang, bang. Holla, laugh now, laugh later.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to another episode of Great Moments in Hater History. I'm your host, Marcus Sullivan. Today we'll be showcasing two of the biggest haters in the history of mankind. The first being Judas Iscariot, who was the right-hand man of Jesus up into a few pieces of events, mainly being about 30 or so, caused him to change his viewpoint on Jesus. And we're also going to be showcasing a lesser-known but incredibly feisty and incredibly hateful Mabel. She's quite the character. Once again, my name is Marcus Sullivan, and we'll be back in a moment.
All I'm saying is, man, you know, Jesus be taking all my shine. Like, you know, that could have been me. Like, take for instance, remember we was at the party the other night? He got to turn the water into wine. Like, I got some wine right here. I could have went to the store, got the wine, and been good. Like, Peter, that's your boy. What you got to say?
And to tell you the truth, when I'm out in public, I act like I don't even know him.
All I'm saying is, man, something needed to be done. I mean, that's just like the other night, we on the boat. What he got to do? He got to go walk on water. I could have did that too, man. Like, Thomas, what you say?
I doubt it. How could you?
Bruh, all I'm saying is, man, Jesus just be taking off. Like, we the disciples. We in these streets.
Out here.
Like, so, I mean, he need to give us some credit. That's just like, okay, take for instance, last week, he gonna try to feed the multitude with the fish and the bread. Like, I could have went to the store and got some bread. And, I mean, I'm a fisherman. I could have went and got some fish. Like, Peter, that's your boy. What's up with him?
Look, don't tell nobody else that I know him.
Thomas?
5 loaves of bread. I doubt it, dude. Be realistic.
All I'm saying is, too, I mean, that even goes to the other time we was in town and the woman was trying to grab the hem of his garment. Like, look at the garments I got on. My garments are fresh. Nice. Like, you know, that could have been my garment that healed him. But he had to step in my way, man. Like, I don't like what he's doing. Like, Peter, that's your boy, man. Like, you done known him. Like, what's up with him?
I know him? I don't really know him.
All I'm saying is, man, something need to be done, man. Like, I'm thinking about dropping a dime. Like, I was talking to the Romans, man, and they don't like him either. So all I'm saying is, like, what I'm really thinking about doing, turn to me and drop a dime, because I don't like that. Mm-mm. I don't like that, man.
You sure?
See, I knew. See, Peter, that's you saying you sure because that's your boy.
I mean, Jesus done a lot for us, man.
So is that or is that not your boy?
I mean, what are the pros and cons? I mean,
all I'm saying is, look, I'm going to go over and holler these Romans, and I'm going to see what's up because, when history get wrote, I want to be the one taking the credit. He just taking all my shine. Look, y'all can stay here if y'all want to. I'm going to go holler these Romans, get my shine back.
Man, can you believe this dude?
And Judas is, yeah, cutthroat snake, a serpent.
Man, I'm about to go holler at Jesus about this one, man. Get up with you, bro.
I don't know about all this. Man, I doubt it.
Salon has shampoo and styles for only $25 and relaxers for only $30. Don't forget, if you send three, your next style is free. Call 225-248-1421 at Hair Artifice Salon, home of the five-star look for less. That's Hair Artifice Salon at 225-248-1421.
Hey, yo, this your boy Benzino, a.k.a. Zeno Grigio, and right now, you're checking out Mad Game TV.
Tonight, on an episode of Meters, we investigate a suspected dietary cheater. Sarah, of 25 years old, is a vegetarian model who loves animals and is suspecting that her fiancé of 2 years is cheating on her. Sarah's fiancé, Chris, is a 40-year-old yoga instructor who owns his own businesses. He was also a former spokesperson for PETA.
Chris has just been acting really strange lately. I mean, normally when I call him, he's always so excited to hear from me. But lately, he won't even answer my calls. And he just sends me straight to voicemail. And when he does call back, it always sounds like it's brushing his teeth. I know, it's probably just, it's all in my head. Because Chris would never cheat.
Now, Sarah, we wanted to get down to the bottom of the suspicion involving Chris. So we set up a surveillance outside of his studio. We wanted to make sure that Chris was where he said he was when you called him. Well, look at what we found.
Your boy T Turner, laugh now, laugh later. We took it to the streets. My boy Cosmo Pacheco, he about to bust that.
Turn, 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 turn
What up, people? Your boy T Turner, laugh now, laugh later. I'm still downtown. I'm still kicking it in my thinking spot, you know, on the levee. That's where I do the. I come here and I think. That's what I like to do. So, while I'm thinking about the next move and pondering, you know, thinking of a master plan, I want y'all to check my homie Mike T out in the lab. Laugh now, laugh later. Be right back.
Now I don't know what life would be in H-I-P, H-O-P without the boy H-O-V. Not only N-Y-C, I'm hip-hop safe.
What is going on, everybody? How you guys are doing? I hope you guys are enjoying your Saturday. I hope you guys are also enjoying Laugh Now, Laugh Later. Season 5 has come to an end, ladies and gentlemen. This is The Lab, and my name is Mike T. We have a lot of new sneakers coming out this week. Starting this Friday, October 3rd, Reebok has another installment in the Kamikaze series. Now, they're coming out this week with the Kamikaze. It's a different colorway. It's kind of flashy. It's got a little pink in it. It's got a little gray in it. And it's pretty dope, man. It's going to be retailed at $110 this week. So this Friday, be on the lookout for Reebok and the Kamikaze 2. Now, a lot of people may say that this is the year of the Air Jordan 6. And then you got some people that may say this is the year of the Air Jordan 13. Well, this Saturday, another 13 is driving. It is the Air Jordan Retro 13 Premium, which is known as the 3M. Now, I don't know what the 3M stands for, but that's the name of the shoe. Now, a lot of people may get this shoe confused with the Baron. It's a similar colorway, but it's a little bit different. Now, this shoe, what makes it different, it has like a pink bottom. It's still gray with a little black in it. You know, it's pretty cool. I probably will cop me a pair because I am a 13 fan. But be on the lookout for the Air Jordan 13, the 3M, which retails at, of course, $185. Yeah, $185. So be on the lookout for that shoe. All right. Now, I don't know what's going on this week, but it seems like the popular color for the release of all shoes this week has to do with the color pink. Foamposite is back again. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, the Nike has decided to drop another Foamposite, which is actually a limited release, and it is an elephant print Foamposite. It drops this Saturday. It's black with a little white, you know, sort of similar to the elephant print on the Air Jordan 3. Well, they put it on the Foamposite with a little pink involved in it, too. It's pretty cool. I'm not actually a Foamposite fan, but I know my Foamposite heads are going to love this shoe. It retails at $250. I'm pretty sure you guys already know that. But be on the lookout this Saturday as well for the new Foamposite 1. Just in case you guys didn't know, Kevin Durant has decided to turn down the Under Armour deal, and he stayed with Nike. Now, Nike came back to the table with an amazing offer of $300 million with some extra incentives as far as retirement plan and whatnot and another whatever. So Kevin Durant is staying with Nike, and he's back in the building with another shoe off of the KD7 line. Now, this KD7 is pretty smooth. It's going to be, I'm going to keep it real with y'all. It's going to be dope for all y'all Saints fans out there, because the color of the shoe is black with a little gold in it, and it's real smooth and it's real cool. You guys are going to like it. And Kevin Durant, he said he wanted to stay up under the $100 range, but the retail of this shoe was $140, which is not too bad, you know, but and it's still kind of affordable and it's still going to be exclusive. So for all of you guys out there, I know a lot of KD fans out there, and I know a lot of people are happy that KD is staying with Nike. So be on the lookout as well this week for Kevin Durant's new shoe, the KD7. It's going to be fly. So now that I got you guys caught up with the sneaker news, let's move on over to a little bit of hip hop. Now, for all my hip-hop fans out there, I know you guys are familiar with the group Slaughterhouse. Well, one of the members of Slaughterhouse by the name of Joel Ortiz is hitting the streets with a solo album by the name of House Slippers. Now, Joel Ortiz, he's coming back with the, he's like one of the meanest cats out of Brooklyn. The album is pretty dope, and I know I use that word a lot, but when I say it, I mean it. The album is complete with a few bangers. It's got some features on it that you don't want to miss, you know, from everybody from the Slaughterhouse members themselves to cats like Mano. You know, the production is off the hook. The album has 12 tracks on it, so whenever you get a little time or get a little break and you need some hip-hop in your life, go check out my boy Joel Ortiz and the new album House Slippers. So right now, if you're from Mississippi or if you know anybody from Mississippi, I'm gonna need you to stand up, because Mississippi's own Big Crit is back again with another mixtape by the name of See Me On Top Volume 4. Now, this is supposed to be something that's supposed to hold us down until the Cadillacta album comes out. But, I mean, to me, in my opinion, new music is new music, whether it's mixtape or whether it's an album. So be on the lookout for Big Crit's new mixtape, See Me On Top Volume 4. I mean, it's a fully loaded mixtape, 22 tracks. It's got features from everybody from Fabulous to Juicy J to Rico Love. It's got all the underground bangers on there. So go to your favorite downloading site, DatPiff, Live Mixtapes, whatever your choice may be, and go download that new Big Crit. Well, there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. This season of The Lab is complete. I would like to thank all the good people over at Laugh Now, Laugh Later and Mad Game ENT. And remember, my name is Mike T. Follow me on Instagram, soullab_BR. And if it's something that you like, if it's something that you didn't like, email me. Email me at soullab@ymail.com. My name is Mike T, and I am signing off. Peace.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. And that was the story of Judas. As you can see, hate has no boundaries. It's limitless. And now we'll be showcasing on the next piece, the lesser known hater, Mabel. We'll be back.
I'm Mabel. No last name needed, okay? I'm here to tell you the real story of what happened December 1955. All right? We had just got off from work, me and Rosa. Yeah, our girl, Rosa. We got on the bus and we sat up front. After about 3 stops, white man got on, told Rosa get up. I told her, she bet not move. Me, I told her. I leaned down to roll my panties holes up, and old ruckus took place. They grabbed out of there without a word. Or next thing I know, there's boycotts, signs, and people protesting. Martin Luther the King even got called. Ain't nobody mentioned Mabel. Ain't nobody said a word about Mabel. I was the voice behind all of this. My grandchildren, my great-grandchildren reading about it in the history books, all about Rosa Parks, Rosa Parks. It's a boycott, and she was the freedom and the justice for all. Who talks about Mabel? Nothing. All I got is greens on right now. Wish I'd have never said nothing to Rosa. Then we was friends, and she started acting sedentary, hanging out with the politicians, all them people, what they call it, reverends and all that, like she was something. She more hair different, put it up on top of the head and got a bang. She ain't had no bang before, had rolled up like mine is now. She get all flashy, bought her some kitten heels, watching with all the celebrities. Who and Coretta had dinner every Saturday night. Where was I? Nowhere, on the same bus. Mabel got a story. Talk about Mabel. I'm done. I got to get my greens off. You don't want to hear what Mabel got to say anyway. My great-grandchildren and I got the babysitting. But let me tell you something. I'll tell you this. I'm going to write about it. You're going to hear what really happened. It was about Mabel and not about her. I don't care that M become before RS. Mabel is here. Rosa is gone. Cut this camera off. I'm done. I say cut it!
And ladies and gentlemen, that concludes another episode of Great Moments in Hater History. Sure, you've stumped your toe into the edge of the bed, and you've hated it. Sure, there are people that you probably work with and They're mildly disgusted with your presence in the break room early in the morning. But surely, as you can see, hate is much stronger than that. As always, I'm your host, Marcus Sullivan. Don't be a hater, unless you're going to be the greatest hater in history. As always.
I don't get tired.
I don't get tired.
I don't fucking get tired. I don't fucking get tired.
Bennington Walsh here, reporting to you live with this Channel 15 News late-breaking exclusive news story. His music is real, raw, and emotional. His rise to fame, meteoric. His Instagram posts are legendary. I'm talking about none other than famed Baton Rouge rapper Kevin Gates, whose hashtag IDGT movement, that's I Don't Get Tired movement, has taken the world by storm via social media. It's with a heavy heart that I must report that video has surfaced of the seemingly tireless rapper doing indeed just that, sleeping. I must warn of those of you who are true Kevin Gates fans, this video may be hard to watch. Let's take a look. Now that you've seen that horrific and shocking video, I'm going to take to the streets to interview some music insiders as well as Kevin Gates fans to see their reaction. Let's go. Hey now, what you say now? I'm here with LaTangela, and she is a musical expert entrenched in the community. I'm here to get your thoughts on this new Kevin Gates viral video that has hit the net like a ton of bricks. It apparently shows Kevin Gates getting, dare I say, tired?
No way. I haven't seen anything about that. I mean, clearly that's a lie because, you know, everybody's on the I Don't Get Tired movement. I'm on it. As a matter of fact, I'm sipping on some of my I Don't Get Tired juice right now because I've been up for the last, let's just say I'm not even going to count the hours, but I don't get tired. Ain't no videos out like that.
What would you say if I told you there was a video out there like that?
I'd say show it to me.
Roll that footage.
I don't get tired, man. I've been trying to tell people, you know. I've been doing it. You know, it wasn't nothing given to me.
LaTangela, now that you've...
Hey, this can't be true. This isn't Kevin. Kevin don't get tired.
It is Kevin.
I've been up for the last 72 hours. Wait. My nerves bad. I've been working, going in. Even Chris Brown don't get tired no more. And you mean to tell me Kevin's sleeping on the job? You know what? Here, you take this. Take it.
There you have it, folks. Apparently a sad day in the music industry. IDGT is apparently no more. This is Bennington Walsh reporting live. Bennington Walsh here for Channel 15 News. I'm here with the DJ Incredible. And DJ Incredible, you're a man in the music industry. How do you feel about Kevin Gates getting tired, sir?
Getting tired? He got tired?
Yes, sir.
He got tired?
Yes, sir.
No, tell me it's not true. You mean...
It is true.
You mean Kevin Gates got tired?
Roll that beautiful bean footage. Sir, how do you feel about the apparent footage that you have just seen?
Oh, my goodness. This is a travesty. Kevin Gates got tired.
I can't believe it either, sir.
First, milk is almost $5 a gallon. Now Kevin Gates got tired. What is the world coming to?
I cannot believe it. It's shocking, isn't it?
I'm going home.
There you have it. Another crushed soul at this startling development. My search for nuance in this late-breaking developmental story has led me out into the streets where I'm asking the average Kevin Gates fan or Gateshead how they feel about this stunning development in the IDGT movement. Sir, you're a Kevin Gates fan, right?
Yeah, you know I rock with him. You know, I model my whole game after Gates. You've heard me?
Sir, what would you say if I told you there were a video out there in which Kevin Gates, leader of the IDGT movement, got tired?
Man, thug, look, that's retarded, bro. Like, Gates don't get... Man, look here, man. I had to see proof of that, bro, because, I mean, I'm saying, like, you know, I don't get tired, man. Like, we out here for real, man. I'm out here in the trap. I started trapping because I was listening to Gates. You heard me?
Roll that footage.
Son, you supposed to eat the booty, you know what I'm saying? What we do. In the real, I'm gonna tell you, we eat the booty.
Okay, sir, you've just seen the footage. How does that make you feel as a Gates fan?
Listen, sir, I can't get with the Gates movement anymore. I'm not even a real trapper, okay? It's just, you know what? Forget all this. Listen, I'm going back to my job, you know. I'm done.
Well, there you have it, folks. This apparent stunning development has just even exposed those who we once thought were about that life. It's just a sad, sad day. And there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. The impossible has apparently happened. Kevin Gates has gotten tired. You know, ladies and gentlemen, there are just some moments in which every American remembers where they were when it happened. The Apollo moon landing, the assassination of John F. Kennedy, Barack Obama being elected president. To Kevin Gates, getting tired is just one of those moments. And I'm sure that I, not alone, I speak for everybody when I say I will remember where I was the day that Kevin Gates got tired. On a more personal note, you know, a journalist is supposed to stay unbiased, but, well, I just don't think it's right that, Gates, why did you get tired? I mean, doggone it, I supported the IDGT movement. I stayed up days, weeks, months without ever going to sleep, and now this? I guess it's true, karma does come around and you'll get back what you did. This has been Bennington Walsh reporting live for Channel 15 News. I'm signing off.
Alright, people, that's it. That's a wrap. Laugh Now, Laugh Later Season 5 is in the books, and this book is officially closed. We really hope that you guys enjoyed the show every week, allowing us to come into your homes, onto your computer screens, however you watched us. We really appreciate the fact that you allowed us to come in and entertain you every week. And now, it's on to the next move. What's the next move? Well, the next move is...
a lot of action right now. And I know you put me on my feet and all, but... I mean, it's time for me to grow. You gotta let me go, baby. You gotta let me go. I'm done for now, so one for now. Possibly forever, we had fun together. But like all good things, we must come to an end. Please show the same love to my friends, dear Summer.